From above, one gets a breathtaking view of this majestic mountain range, a chain of peaks holding the beauty of what seems like an untouched world. Tropical virgin forests, stunning waterfalls, and ancient natural wonders. All these are playgrounds to some of the most diverse, rare, and vulnerable species. As well as home to the native Subanun River people and the spirits of their forebears. This is Mount Malindang Range Natural Park, a protected heritage of exceptional natural beauty, biodiversity, and mystery. The Malindang Mountain Range straddles Misamis Occidental and Zamboanga Peninsula, dramatically rising up to 2,404 meters above sea level. It displays its grandeur over Osamis City and its neighboring towns. For Mount Malindang's crucial significance to life, culture, and survival, it was proclaimed a national park and watershed area in 1971, a protected area under the National Integrated Protected Area System, or NIPAS, in 2002, and an ASEAN Heritage Park in 2011.
Mount Malindang is composed of 53,028 hectares. Ito ay may dalawang zone, buffer zone at saka core zone. So yung core zone naman, ito yung pinoprotektahan talaga nila at saka sa gobyerno natin dahil ito yung pinagmula nung strength ng bundok as a watershed and a life source and a carbon dioxide sink of Misamis Occidental.
Designated for conservation is 34,000 hectares of wilderness, dense forests and woodlands, rugged canyons and ravines, surprisingly, amphitheater-like landscape and sinkholes believed to have been formed by volcanic eruptions eons ago. This vast forest cover is impressive, not just for its beauty, but for its diversity.
Makikita natin dito sa Mount Malindang, sa core zone area, yung mga species na, like ridlawaan, igim, tanggili. Sa center banda ng Mount Malindang, makikita yung napakalaking area ng Almasiga Forest. Dito lang makikita yung Medinilla malindangensis.
Mount Malindang is a critical habitat of over 1,000 wildlife species.
Ang Bukid Malindang ay rich po ng biodiversity. Ito ay home ng 142 species na dito lang makikita sa Malindang.
Water is a lifeblood that flows through Mount Malindang.
Ang Mount Malindang kasi is composed of 16 major watersheds. So sa likod ko, isa na yun. Ito yung headwater ng Salog River that drained to Zamboanga del Sur. Mount Malindang is a watershed of three provinces, namely the Misamis Occidental, Zamboanga del Sur, at saka Zamboanga del Norte.
These extensive river systems supply fresh, potable water to over 1 million residents. And then there's the theatrical display of nature's beauty, strength, and even magic.
Pinagmalaki ng Mount Malindang itong nasa likod ko, yung Curtin Falls.
Sometimes the lake becomes an oasis of incantations summoning the spirits.
Tabia tago basta nabuat saglit duminagat.
The Subbanon, the only ethnic settlers in the province, have a special relationship with nature.
Ang Lake Duminagat ay importante para sa mga Subbanon dahil dito sila nag-renew ng kanilang vows on their spiritual beliefs. Yung Great Balayan nila ay nanggaling doon sa Lake Duminagat. Doon siya nakatira. Yun yung si Apo Mali. So, talagang importante sa kanila at pinag-preserve nila yung place dahil sa connection nila sa kanilang Panginoon.
Custodians of their homeland, they are striving to keep and practice their traditions in the face of danger of disappearance.
Ang Bukid Malindang, importante gina sa amo kay sa kaniadto, mao ginay amo ang kadangpan o panginabuhian, mao ang Mount Malindang, tungod kay anaa diha ang mga espirituhanon, amo ang balaan, ang Bukid nga Malindang. So mao na ang amo agyong gi mahal ang Mount Malindang gikan sa kaniadto sa among mga ginikanan ug hantog garon. Kami nagpabilin usa ka Subbanon ginsalugan diri sa Mount Malindang. Mao na ka importante sa amo.
Malaking issue o problema ng Mount Malindang ay yung expansion ng mga farmlots ng mga nanirahan sa Curzon. He opened the area for their Sayuti garden.
The slash and burn farming leads to soil erosion, destruction of habitat, forest fire, and biodiversity loss, and ultimately contributes to climate change. And when mass tourism, overdevelopment, and commercial interests take precedence, the delicate ecological balance will be tipped.
Nakikita nila na may tourism potential ang Mount Malindang, kaya sila bumili ng mga area, ano? Katulad ng sa Mansawan. Dahil ang Mansawan ay entrance sa papuntang Lake Duminagat.
With 34% of Mount Malindang already cleared, its remaining forest cover needs to be conserved and protected before it's too late. Urgently tackling this biodiversity crisis is a Department of Environment and Natural Resources and the Protected Area Management Board. Through the involvement of community in environmental education and regular monitoring of illegal activities, locals developed a sense of ownership, making them mindful of the environment that sustains them.
Ang Mount Malindang, wala kamo arag yung grupo nga lumad nga tribo na protektar sa Mount Malindang tungod kay nakita namo nga kami mga lumad nga tribo, ang Mount Malindang ang ayong protektahan namo tungod kay dili pwede nga hukdon ang mga kakahuyan o mga mananap, tanan nga mga mananap sa kabukiran, dili pwede paghilabtan o mga kakahuyan. Kay kung wala na mga kahoy sa kabukiran, sa ato ang Malindang, wala na po tayo tubig, kay mamala na siya o mahubas, so wala na panginabuhian ang katawhan. So mao na kaming mga Subbanon nga grupo, nga gupom, sa tasatagsa na mo ka mga teritoryo ng mga lungsod o barangay, ang mga gukom di ang mga tribal chieftain mo na protektar sa amo ang kabukiran sa Mount Malindang. Kami gumawa mga lumad.
Hindi lang tayo sa more on preservation, but meron din tayong dinidevelop na mga ecotourism sites para naman maibalanse yung conservation at saka development within Mount Malindang. So sa ngayon, hindi natin inaayawan yung may balak na gagawang mga man-made ecotourism within the protected area for as long as may approval ng PAMBI, kinukonsulta doon ng mga IP.
Sustainable development and impact monitoring of ecotourism help conserve and preserve the unique attractions as well as the sacred sites and the natural landscapes.
Yes, Mount Malindang is open for the public, but the Office of the Protected Areas will issue first a permit to climb before going to Mount Malindang. Mayroon tayong ina-identify na entrance ng Mount Malindang, dalawa yon. Ang purpose natin na gumawa tayo, ay kinilala natin yon as entry point ng Mount Malindang para mamonitor lahat yung umaakyat. Mayroon rin tayong exit, kinokontrol natin yung carrying capacity ng mga natural ecotourism sites natin. We limit the climbers into 5 to 10 to avoid yung disturbance ng ecosystem o biodiversity doon sa Mount Malindang.
Livelihood trainings aim to build capacities among the Sabanon people lead to the development of sustainable income sources.
Ang Protected Area Management Office sa ngayon ay nagbibigay ng mga training para sa livelihood ng mga IPs. Isa sa pinaka-progressive na livelihood na naibigay namin ay yung abaca production at saka yung kalya lili para sa mga women's na nakatira sa Lake Dominagat. Yung bulaklak ng kalya lili, nag-harvest nila dalawang beses isang linggo. Ito ay nagagamit nila sa pagsuporta sa kanilang mga anak at sa kabuhayan nila.
The future of Mount Malindang is a shared vision, a joint undertaking that relies on the collaboration of government and the local community.
We should hand in hand to support Malindang, to protect Mount Malindang from disaster, from threatening expansion of gardens, farmland, and improper implementation of ecotourism. Sana pipiliin natin ang project, appropriate project para sa isang ecotourism site. At sana ang mga tao sa tatlong probinsya ay susuporta sa advokasya ng Mount Malindang para mapanatili natin ito na buhay. Dahil ito ay buhay, Mount Malindang is a source of life. Mount Malindang is life for all of us.
Today, our crusade of protecting one of the last remaining forests in the Philippines continues, with its success critically hinged on the commitment of local leaders and stakeholders. Ultimately, how we translate our commitment to tangible actions will determine the future of our natural treasure, the Mount Malindang Range Natural Park. Beyond the city of Zamboanga, its booming economy, reflected in its vibrant streetscape and colorful cultural attractions, another jewel crowns the southern part of the Philippines, one that is gleaming with crystal clear waters, cutting across polished stones and green terrain. A treasure so alive, yet so fragile, this is the Pasonanca Natural Park.
Thank you.
Considered as one of the last remaining old-growth forests of Mindanao, the Pasunanca Natural Park encompasses 12 municipalities.
Yung 12,000 hectares po, wala tayong inhabitants yan sa loob, no? Yun po ang isang magandang condition ng forest natin na walang settlements sa loob ng strict protection zone. Yung original na 10,560 hectares, yun po ang Los Canopy Forest. And then sa perimeter po nito, may tawag tayong buffer zone. Nandiyan po yung mga communities adjacent sa watershed.
As a protected area, the park cradles diverse species of flora and fauna. More critically, it supplies water to the locality for domestic, industrial, and agricultural purposes.
Bago po ito naging Pasunanca Natural Park, pinaklaim muna itong isang Pasunanca Forest Reserve. Then through PP 199 po yun. Then nung pumasok po yung NIPAS Act of 1992, through Proclamation 132, naka po siya naging Pasunanca Natural Park. Just recently, na-legislate na po siya nung ma-amend ang RA 7586 to RA 11038. Being categorized as natural park, ang Pasunanca Natural Park po natin ay 90% po siya old growth forest. And it is mostly dominated with 70, more or less 70 species of dipterocarps. Kino-consider po siyang home ng of the 96 proclaimed na most threatened and premium species in the Philippines by the Binhi ng EDC. 11 po ng 96 ay nandito po sa Pasunanca Natural Park. Example po na yung almond, white lawaan, yakal na rig, yakal manggisuso. And aside po dyan sa fauna po natin, marami pong makikita ditong Mindanao at Sambuanga endemic sa mammals, reptiles, amphibians, most especially sa birds. Ang bird watching po natin dito ay karamihan mga foreigners. Dito po sila nasasatisfy kasi yung mga hinahanap po nilang species ng birds na wala sa ibang lugar ay dito po nakikita sa Pasunanca.
The Pasunanca National Park is very, very important in Sambuanga Peninsula, especially in Sambuanga City. There is the watershed that provides the water needs of Sambuanga City as a whole. Then it also supports the education system here in this region.
Nandito po sa loob ng Pasunanca National Park, mayroon tayong tatlong sub-catchment area. So, dyan sa tatlong sub-catchment area, nandyan po ang galing yung river tributaries na nagsusupply po ng tubig para sa Sambuanga City.
Ensuring the long-term protection of the park are passionate stakeholders who work closely with the Department of Environment and Natural Resources. They have active representations in the Protected Area Management Board, or PAMBI, the highest policy-making body within the park. Over the years, linkages and partnerships have been strengthened to implement sustainable programs to protect the park.
Connection, nakipag-link sa iba-ibang organization. Ang ginawa ko nang una, nag-connect ako sa mga scientists ng UST, scientists ng San Carlos University, at saka yung sa MIT, MIT sa Iligan. So dinala ko sila dito kami nakatira. Tapos, na-found out namin na marami pala mga bagong species na na-discover nila. May bago kaming mistletoe, may bago kaming amorphophallus, may bago kaming mga iba't ibang punong kahoy na hindi na-discover nung una. Kasi bihira nga ang pupunta dito. So dinala ko sila, tapos to connect again, tinawag ko yung tatlong councilor ng city, especially yung chairman ng environment, sa tourism, at saka kung tatlo sila pumunta dito, pinasyo namin yung na-discover namin. At tuwang-tuwa sila, kaya nga suportado nila ito kung anong gusto natin gawin because of that.
Protection and conservation po ng Pasunanca Natural Park. May mga security BMS station na nilagay namin sa surrounding perimeter. So we employ 119 guards distributed ito sa 29 station ng BMS para sila po ang magbabantay 24/7 yung area ng Pasunanca Natural Park. And then sa interior part po ng watershed, meron din kaming station sa mga main junction ng rivers. So may management plan kami na na-update ngayon po para sa 5-year plan para sa protection, conservation and maintenance ng Pasanaka Natural Park. So incorporated po dyan sa management plan yung livelihood para sa person, yung development po sa person.
Ang grupo namin, yung Industrial Group of Zamboanga Incorporated, is really interested in being a major stakeholder in the conservation preservation of the Pasanangka Natural Park. In fact, we were the ones who requested the Protected Area Management Board that we be allowed to be a member of the board, because we have a great stake in the preservation of the watershed. More than 70% ng membership companies ng industrial group ay atin mga producer ng sardinas. Lahat ng brand ng sardinas nakikita nyo sa department store and grocery stores ay galing dito at gawa dito sa Zamboanga. Kailangan ma-preserve namin ang watershed dahil ang mga tamban at ang mga sardinas na nilalata namin ay nanggagaling lang din dito sa mga dagat natin na surroundings. Kung anong mangyari sa dagat, dahil parte ito sa ecosystem, nanggagaling din yan sa watershed at sa mga rivers, sa ilog, sa mga ano natin. At dadaloy lahat yan sa dagat. Kung hindi namin i-preserve yung dagat kung saan namin kinukuha yung isda para ilata, then mamawala kami ng negosyo, nawawala ng industriya, nawawala ng empleyo, lahat, no? Magiging apekto.
Nung pumasok, ma'am, yung National Greening Program, na gumawa kami ng mga, nag-procure kami ng mga seedlings tulad ng cacao. At nung 2013, nagtanim kami ng mga puno tulad ng nara, dao, at saka mulabe. Yun ang unang project namin. Nagtanim kami sa boundary ng protected area. Tanim din kami sa gilid ng mga ilog, sapa, hanggang natapos kami ang 215 hectares. Malaki talagang tulong ng DNR, kasi kung wala sila sa aming likod, hindi sila nagtuturo kung paano kami mabubuhay, wala kami alam. At saka yung mga illegal na hindi namin alam noon. Sa tulong ng seminar palagi ng DNR at saka partner talaga DNR at saka Water District, sila talaga ang nagtutulong sa amin para binigyan sa amin ng edukasyon.
As the morning sun glistens over the waters, stewards of the Pasanangka Natural Park start their work. They implement environmental policies, set targets, collaborate on conservation projects aimed at protecting this fragile treasure in Zamboanga.
As a birder, gusto namin makikita talaga yung nest ng Philippine Eagle. Kasi as yung sa mga bird watcher, yun talaga ang pinakadulo nila. Yung nakikita lang namin lumilipad, nakapulot na kami ng feather, pero ang nest talaga to prove kung nandyan. Ginagawa namin na natural park ito ngayon, gusto namin maging mga Asian Heritage Park. So, ginagawa namin ang documentation dito, kaya nga, kinukuha na namin yung mga result ng mga scientists para yun ang ilagay namin para maging Asian Heritage. Kasi ngayon, ang nagpuprotekta karamitan dito is yung tinatawag nilitong Guardia Monte or Forest Guard. May 128 more or less silang Forest Guard na umiikot dito, nagtitingin, pinoprotektahan nila. Gusto namin sa susunod na kung i-capacitate yung community. Marami kasing komunidad sa paligid, hindi sa loob, na sila nang muprotekta sa masarap kasi pag community na, no? Wala ka ng gasto sila na makabenefit pa sila sa kung anong makukuha dito.
I am announcing it now that we people of Region 9 and we are also asking the help of the national government to put some developmental programs within this area to protect this. I am certain that if this will be protected, this will add to the beauty and at the same time, the prestige of Philippines as one of the best protected area that we have here, especially in this region.
Today, people and institutions are determined to honor their covenant of protecting the Pasunanca Natural Park. More than just a water resource and treasure trove of biodiversity, the park is their very own slice of paradise, nestled in the land of promise that is Zamboanga.